Okay, folks, with that, we're into it. We have got some stake gaming action liquids here too. Always a lot of fun, and yeah, I do believe we're ready to go. Once again, I'm Llama Down Under. I'm going to be joined by the Wonder Cow, who I've actually left unmuted this whole time, so I'm very glad you weren't making any noise.
You know what?
Ten
That is
seconds
the double
remaining.
mute solution.
Excellent.
Always fixes it.
Yep,
So
radiant
we
team
were
leader.
real. I'm pretty excited to get to cast this one. Other than through the open qualifiers, haven't casted too much state gaming, and of course Liquid's always a pleasure to cast, but after last game, I don't know how much of that you caught, Gorgon. Did you see what Liquid did last set?
10 seconds
Caught
remaining.
nothing of the last
Damn.
game. I was too busy writing,
They picked
so.
a support
5 seconds
lifestealer, which
remaining.
that's a choice in of itself.
That's a choice, yeah.
Then he
Yeah.
got a Radiance.
Team Liquid,
And
turn to battle.
was no longer a support lifestealer. It was special. It
Wait,
was.
what time did this radiance come out? Was it like a support lifestealer radiance,
I'm
or
not
was
so
it did he get
sure.
some farm?
Right, he got some farm. There were kills to be had, but I'm doing
Radiant
like what you're
team
saying. I'm
pick.
working, watching the Dota on the side. Here, Cap and Toby making some jokes about support lifestealer. I'm like, okay, there's a support
Team
lifestealer. Here,
Liquid,
Cap and Toby
turn to
make some
pick.
jokes about a radiance. There's a radiance. It was very interesting. But we're in a different game
Team
entirely. We'll
Liquid, turn to
see if Stake can
battle.
do something. And we have a lot of bans and picks
Radiant
flying out.
team
Stake
pick.
get the Invoker, but of course lose out on the Darkseer and Gyro. A little surprised that Team Liquid went with the Darkseer.
Well, it fits out with the gyrocopter very well. It's a nice semi-ish counter to a lot of your late game DPSers, including to some degree the Invoker. He's been rising in popularity since, I want to say, October, maybe even
10
a little
seconds
earlier than
remaining.
that. Even through late 6/8/4, he started to get a bit of a boost, and
5 seconds
it's been
remaining.
rocky for him, but he's still on the rise.
Yeah, and it's not that Darkseer's bad by any means. I'm just
Radiant
wondering
team
if
back.
they that they prioritize him over maybe some of these other strong supports we've been seeing
Team
come out.
Liquid's
Like the
turn to
Tusk, I
battle.
believe Team Liquid, they used to, maybe not so true on this patch, but they on 6.85 I think had a 80% win rate on Tusk, whether it was played support or offlane, so.
Yeah, and they do
10 seconds
very frequently pick up
remaining.
Tusk for their first pick, and in about half of their games, their first pick is
Radiant
Tusk.
team back.
They typically, though, when they do have that Darkseer come out, it's often an early ban. So lately, in their last 5 or 6 games, we've been seeing a lot of first round picks on the Darkseer for Team Liquid. So it seems to be something that they are keen
Ten
on
seconds
experimenting with.
remaining.
Yeah, and I think it's always nice to make
Five
sure.
seconds
I
remaining.
mean, when you look at State Gaming's bans, both of these are fodder bans, but also fodder has this nasty
Reserve
habit
time.
of even if you shut him down a bit, he's just very consistent. He'll find a way to get the farm, and he maybe won't be making the flashy plays, but he'll come back and bite you in the rear for getting consistent farm. But Lone Druid ban out as well, and there it is, finally.
Yeah.
Finally, the
Team
Earth
Liquid's
Spirit.
turn to battle.
Earth Spirit is one of 3 heroes this patch that gets banned on average in the first ban phase. So to see him go all the way to the end of the second ban phase without a ban or a pick is kind of weird, to be honest.
I think
10 seconds remaining.
this past Star Ladder, a lot of people are
Five
thinking they
seconds
know what to
remaining.
do with the Earth Spirit, but also maybe Team Liquid deciding it can wait, they
Team
want other
Liquid's
things.
turn to pick.
I feel like we've talked about it yesterday and the day before. This patch
Yeah.
seems a lot more open
Radiant
with how you
team
can
pick.
draft it. And for example, we were seeing, I think, all of yesterday Venge in the first two picks, and now
Yeah.
she comes out third pick here,
Dazzle.
wasn't banned, and a dazzle.
Yeah,
Team
a lot of that
Liquid's
does come
turn
down
to
to
pick.
there hasn't been a tremendous number of Class A events that have all of the world's best teams playing so far this patch either. You had the Summit, which had a lot of the world's best teams, and you had a Star Ladder I-League, right? But other than that, you haven't seen a whole lot of activity on 686. There's been a lot of tournaments like WePlay that get a
Radiant
wide
team
range of
pick.
teams put together, and that doesn't really give you the same meta formation that you'll get when you get the top 12 teams in the world together. So I would honestly expect the meta to remain relatively fluid all the way up until the major, where we're going to see presumably some more hard patterns kind of fall into place.
Yeah, and we're seeing the Puck from Team Liquid. This is another hero that
Ten
it's been
seconds
shown can have a
remaining.
huge amount of impact. Liquid did just play it in their last game, but
Five
I'd be
seconds
interested.
remaining.
Obviously, it's something, it can be a solid pickup, but I also wonder if they're trying to use some of these games as kind of time. Practice. Because it's nothing, you can scrim all you want, but nothing beats playing against people on a hero that you want to make sure you get more practice on in an official match.
Yeah, especially this is a best of one, so they kind of just can, they can afford to have a couple throwaway games. And Puck is not a tremendously popular hero, but he is a hero that is growing in popularity. And if you are Team Liquid and you want to try out the Puck strategy, WePlay is a great place to do it. Not only are you going to go up against opponents that are not as experienced as you, but also opponents that are not as highly ranked as you, such as State Gaming. So I totally agree. It seems like a good strategy to go with a hero that you want to improve on in games like this. Turn
to bad. And State counter with the Disruptor. There's a couple of nice heroes for this Disruptor to counter. Obviously, the big one is the Darkseer. Also, Fenge swaps someone to safety. Radiant, you can glimpse them back in. Although the reverse of that, of course, is if you glimpse someone back, Venge might swap them. But it does seem like a nice all-around pick here. It just does feel that State Gaming is a little bit light on Shore Lockdown. You've got a bunch of stuff from Invoker. You've got the Lasso from Batrider, but kind of nothing else.
Yeah, the other thing is that they don't really have a lot of health, right? Invoker has regen, but in terms of just sheer ability to stand up and face tank, the right clicks that are going to be coming out from Darkseer Illusions, from the Gyrocopter, and from the Vengeance Aura, making everybody just have greater physical damage output, that their overall HP pools are pretty slim. I would expect a farming carry that has a decent HP pool to come out, something maybe like a Spectre.
Yeah, and I mean, I feel like she's very strong right now. She's received a couple of buffs, although I would say they're buffs. It's the lifesteal. Okay, so
hey, yeah, why not? Did they win that last game?
Yeah. Oh, yes. They gave up some kills, but they still won it. They were in control, I would say, for most of the game, from what I saw. Albeit, as I said, I was watching it in the background, but it looks to be a support lifestealer again, I would assume. And they also, I've seen Liquid run before a support Darkseer, but I have to assume it's the support lifestealer. You know, just gotta keep practicing that strat.
Well, they did just run it, right? So it's reasonable to assume that they're going to run it again.
It's warmed up.
Exactly. Warmed up. And once again, that comes down to what we were just saying. If you've got something that you kind of want to try out, it's better to try it out in something like WePlay than it is to try it out in scrims, because teams don't play the same way in scrims that they will play against you when there's something on the line.
Yeah, so either way, it's going to be good. We get a Weaver. This is an interesting one. I feel like Weaver is a kind of popular hero. Depends. It's very player-based, it feels like. There are some players who love her. Him. Sorry, I think Weaver's a chick.
I don't disagree with you. I think you can go any which way on the Weaver as you want. Weaver is sort of played a little bit, almost entirely in that last pick, so very situational grab. I don't think this is the situation. Not only do you have some hard stun action coming out of the Venge and some silence coming out of the Puck, but there continues to try to play as cheekily as he can up here in the top lane. He's doing a fairly good job of grabbing his experience and trying to contest, but he is playing a very dangerous game.
Yeah, and folks, we should be back hopefully in 2 minutes. Joys of having to restart Twitch stuff. And
this is why you buy the in-game ticket, kids. little WePlay pug.
There's a couple different things going on. Hopefully we'll be back in just 2 minutes. So we'll be seeing in this mid lane, it does look like Puck has a little bit of an advantage, but it's relatively even. We'll see how it pans out as things continue. To me, the big thing here is Kuroki is just having the time of his life in the jungle. He's going to be out-leveling the other supports, of course. You know, he's already level 4. Whenever he decides to come out, if he does what he did last game, where I think he picked up an ancient creep and was just harassing everything out of other people.
Yeah, that sounds about right. Especially if you are in the jungle, right? As this you mentioned, Kuroki is. He's not really going to come in with a tremendous amount of... Oh, actually, we got to come back to this because Jerex is being hunted down by Syndra.
Yeah, he's got a couple of stacks on him. He manages to dodge the Sunstrike, but now here comes the Invoker coming in with that Cold Snap. This should be our first Blood fodder, trying to do what he can. If he could get the turnaround on Slicks, that would be pretty big. A few more auto attacks. He misses one uphill. He needs one after this, but the Fairy Fire coming out from Slicks. And now fodder pushed back, but here comes Kuroki saying, "Don't you bully my Puck." And that'll be that.
That's a nice little rotation from Kuroki. You know, he took the time to come out of the jungle, make sure everybody's okay. It may have cost him a touch of farm, but this is the right way to run a jungle, right? Still, you have to be active and aware of what's going on. You can't just AFK at the Centaur camp and come out 20 minutes later. Your team is just going to get thrashed.
Yeah, definitely. And I'm still doing technical troubleshooting, so I'm going to...
go through here, Invoker actually taking Radiant's the time to grab himself a ward for this mid lane, give himself the high ground vision over the nighttime, and be able to harass that puck out a bit. He is doing pretty well, especially considering the early game shenanigans we just saw with that Batrider coming out and harassing him, but he is starting to fall pretty far behind that puck.
Yep. And there we go. We're back, folks. We are back. Yeah. Okay, so we, as you said, Invoker falling behind on puck, even with that first blood. And to me, the scary part is Kuroki hasn't been having any impact anywhere on the map, and, you know, they're still feeling the pressure.
Yeah. Yeah, he had exactly as much impact as he could scare his opponents. This triple stack, part of it just got stolen by Puck as well. Yeah. The big part, as you know, it's the creeps that you really wanted there did not go to the Batrider, which is a bummer.
Seal Kid. Yeah, he's gonna go for the TP, but there's a magic missile at the ready. Jerax being a little rude there. I mean, he's making sure that the shallow grave doesn't take too long, but he could have stopped the TP any time. Seal Kid would be dead.
Yeah, he waited a bit. I think maybe he was hoping to save the mana, but either way, they end up grabbing that kill, evening it out. I'm not entirely sure why he was that deep, but, you know.
It's from the contesting. They contested the hard camp.
But the puck used the illusory orb to contest that camp at the very end from the other side of the trees. I don't think anybody really needed to charge the high ground there, right? He kind of went up there alone. I don't know. It seemed like a maybe slightly over-aggressive play to me. That's all.
And yeah, to catch back folks up, although this will be told, we're having a glimpse back in mid-Fauna. He manages to drop the Dream Coil. They only have the auto attacks. He phase shifts a bunch of them, but one more will get him. A really nice play there coming out of Fog. Catching out the puck, and this is what they need. We talked about it. You got to take advantage of the fact that there is one support not on the map, the Lifestealer, who can't TP in and save people.
Yeah, he's got a headdress as well, so it looks like he's going into a Vlad's. Get that early damage aura as well as the early lifesteal to help his team push. It's not terrible. And he's going to jump into the Ancient Black Dragon, which was actually saved for him last time somebody came through and cleared out the creeps.
It's what they did, I think, last game. Ancient Black Dragon OP-yo. It actually, the fireball is a mini macro fire. If you can use it to push waves, but even without that, if you can lock somebody in it for a little bit, it does huge amounts of damage, and they have a magic missile. So here comes Kuro.
It's 850 damage total over 10 seconds. So if you can land one of those that even lasts a decent fraction of the full duration, there's not a lot of heroes that can stand up to it at 7 minutes.
Definitely, and we'll see. Kuro right now is just actually coming to have some presence in the bottom lane. Of course, Mind Control had been forced out of the lane. He is only level 3, but that's about all for Liquid's casualties in this this jungling support Lifestealer. The fact that they're not super behind when it comes to either experience or gold, I think is really impressive, because they are playing a support down, basically.
Yeah, but to be fair, they are maxed.
Dream Coil onto Fog. I don't think there's a great way for the Disruptor to get away. He'll try, but the cooldown. Nice attempt there, but a really nice play by Puck, seeing an easy kill and making sure they get it. And now they're stealing the stacks from Cinderin. Cinderin's going to come in here and try and look pretty, but there's Kuro zoning him with the Black Dragon.
Poor Cinderin cannot catch a break on these stacks, man. He gets his offlane hard camp stolen. He gets his camp in his own jungle stolen. Presumably, this is going to be a tower as well. And Weaver is probably going to have to get himself away here. He does have time lapse, so he should be fine.
It's really rough. I feel that Cinderin has his work cut out for him. He, of course, once he has that blink, he can be much more effective. And there's a lot of nice heroes to pick off here. But until then, he's just got to play it safe.
God, this Black Dragon has so much mana, too, right? It can cast that thing 5 times straight, not including any passive regen that it has. That's insane. That mana pool needs to be dropped down in one of the sub-patches. It really does.
We'll see. It does feel like a lot of the patches, or the last patch, did buff the jungle a significant amount. And we'll see what the exact, whether it gets nerfed in a subsequent patch. I'm not sure. I assume there'll be a patch after the Shanghai Major. But
yeah, there should be 6, 8, 7 or whatever. Usually they've been rotating them after Major, but we might see a small sub-patch before the Major as well. There's still a bit of time, and they often like to do about 6 weeks before the Major actually goes off. They like to do a slight little balance patch. Yeah. Same thing for TIs in the past.
So we'll be seeing Era trying to give Jerax a little bit of the swarm. He gets stunned out here. Who's coming in? It's going to be Puck. Era does get off the Sakuchi in time and should be
Radiant's
fine here.
Tower is under attack.
He's just going to have to play around. He is under a sentry. The Courier. Courier's going to move. Get that Zebra away. Okay, I didn't know the Zebra counted as a unit for the heal. That's fun.
Huh. Yeah, that is interesting. I also did not know that. Well, you learn something new every day. Courier, counts toward Dazzle. Just fly it, just buy a bunch of them and you get instant new. New pub strategy. Buy 100%. Four of them for the mid game and just fly it around under Shadow Blade or something.
We're gonna have the glimpse back, but of course you can use that illusory orb to jump away at any time. So, and Kuro is Radiant's out of one Black Dragon, but ready to hop into another if he so chooses. Oh yeah, he does. So
he couldn't be getting luckier with these with these ancient spawns. There's always a Black Dragon available for him. His team is just about done pushing this mid tower in as well. So even if the Dire do, and they will lose their top tower, they should be up tower here pretty soon.
Yeah. So, looking around, the Midas is up on Invoka. It doesn't look like we have... Oh, Syndrome actually has more than enough money to buy the Blink. I think he wants it from the side shop, so he's greedily farming a little... Oh, as I say that, picks it up from home.
And we just saw the Helm of the Dominator get purchased by Matumba Man on the Gyrocopter as well. He's going to be pulling that out on the courier as we speak.
Yeah, and we will... Okay, thank you, camera. Oh, I hear Puck using that ult again on Fogged. Fogged can't catch a break here. He's going to drop the kinetic field, but end up going down to the rocket barrage. So Liquid score themselves another kill.
Good discipline. Once he got caught out there, it's tempting to throw down the kinetic field and also the static storm and try to use the silence to get away. But there was no getting away there. And really, like I said, good discipline by him to just save the cooldown timer on that.
Yeah, and with these little skirmishes, Liquid is starting to pull ahead in gold and experience. I'm impressed, given that they had the jungling lifestealer, but right now, I guess that time of the game is over. He's got the Vlads up, he can be in birds pushing towers.
Yeah, and why not, right? He's got really nowhere else to be. And he's still getting a bit of experience being up here and playing this way. There's no reaction coming out as well, so why not?
Yeah. So, Syndrome has the blink. We'll see what the first play will be there. He's also picked up a smoke, which has been used. They're acting like they want to go in middle. If he can pick out, he should know which one is the right fodder now. He's pinged it. He's got the lasso. They're gripping him backwards. But there is the swap. The hard counter to the Batrider coming out. And unfortunately, it being nighttime, Syndrome didn't have vision of the Venge.
Do you remember if that Batrider was picked into the Venge or if the Venge was picked into the Batrider?
The first pick was Invoka, and then the Venge was picked. Right?
Okay. So
it was picked into the Venge. No, the Venge was third
Venge
pick.
Was
you're
third.
Right. The Venge was
the Venge
third
was
pick.
Third. So
first
the
pick was Invoka. Bat was one of the first or second Radiant's picks. Maybe second after the Invoka? Yeah, definitely.
Yes, that's exactly what it was. It was Invoka, Batrider, Dazzle, Disruptor, Weaver in order. So. Interesting confidence from State Gaming to not ban out, right, the hard counter of the swap to their Batrider.
I think maybe just worried about some other heroes more, you know? We've seen it time and time again. Depending on what team you're going up against, you might feel that you need to ban everything.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
There is actually, he's farming okay. We can see he has good CS, he has decent farm, but there are so many wards around all the time that I think it's really hard to get anything done here as a Weaver.
Yeah, well, it's not the stage in the game where the Weaver really shines, right? He
top tower
is like
attack.
I said, he's slippery, but he's not particularly beefy. He goes down very quickly if you do get him locked in, and his damage output is not
Radiant's
tremendous through the early
attack.
Game, with the exception of if he manages to get a decent one-on-one. He can get a pretty decent amount of negative armor from the swarm, so if he can catch one person out, he could probably take that fight
attack.
At this stage in the game. But fighting into a team, or into an ancient, or something like that, just won't work until at least the BKB is out.
So what do you think is the game plan here then for Stake Gaming, right? It does feel like Slicks, he just purchased the full Yules. So maybe he'll try to get some single pickoffs. Obviously, they have a lot of good single target kill potential with a Batrider and a Invoker. There's going to be a tiny glimpse fog, again taking the Dream Coil. The Shallow Grave comes out. He is in a lot of trouble still, I think. Gets killed by the creeps.
Not sure why Seal Kid... he probably couldn't have saved him. But I'm not sure why Seal Kid opted to not drop Shadow Wave and Weave there. And so they're both super low cooldown spells. But just kind of leaving Disruptor to... I guess maybe it's sort of like if I call the ambulance, you won't learn your lesson. You know?
I hope that's not how they treat Dota. We're going to see a Yules coming out onto Jerax, but no follow-up. And we need to talk about two things. Obviously, I want to get back to the earlier question, but looking at the map vision from the Dire, they have put down so many sentries. The Radiant have two wards kind of deep, but like this, the Radiant basically have spent three sentries attempting to deward their jungle, and the Dire was just feeling comfortable in there before. I think they caught one ward with that.
Yeah, the other issue is
there's going to be a glimpse back into Static Storm onto Fodder. Can they get enough damage before he gets out of there and is able to use spells? They blow him up. And now Kuroki and the Ancient Black Dragon is going to fly away. So nice pick.
Yeah, that's great. That's exactly what they need. They also maybe need to contest this bottom tower. It's already down below half health. And there just seems to be a lot of hedging on Stake Gaming's part. They don't seem to be willing to engage in a lot of these cases. Which makes sense because they're basically playing down a hero while the Weaver is still trying to get up that BKB.
Oh, we have a smoke. Sindarin's going on a different target than the rest of them. They're going to end up picking off Matumba Man on one side. And now the drag back on Jerax. Jerax moving very fast for a second there. Can they catch her out? There is also Mind Control on the docks here. And now Fodder coming in, drops a big Silence and a Dream Coil. This should set them up for a really nice wall vacuum. But Mind Control has no mana because he didn't go Mana Boots close. Still, they managed to pick off one. Will this help Sindarin get away? No, the vacuum comes out. Sindarin's going to be taking a lot of damage. If Era at the very least can get out, you can argue it's even. And yeah.
He should be able to get away here. He's got a time lapse. He should be able to be slippery enough. They don't have a ton of lockdown. They just have enough lockdown to make it worrisome for him. He may even be going into a Desolator because of their... They have some stuff that might worry a Weaver, but it's not so much of it that he absolutely couldn't, you know, fight around the edges. If he does go into a Desolator, that would give them a lot more fight presence, but it would also be very, very risky. A single Magic Missile could be enough to destroy this Weaver.
Yeah. It's really rough, I think, as Weaver as your carry. Not that there are easy solutions in Dota right now, but obviously the Weaver is very squishy, as you said, and he needs a while to get online.
Yeah, and the Desolator will help him get online. Once again, especially for this like split push, old school oriented Weaver, but there's a reason that you don't normally see that as a standard build, and he is going to Deso. He just picked up his second Mithril Hammer, so he'll have that very shortly. And he should be able to go down a lane while the rest of his team kind of forces engagements around the map. I'm just not sure if he's going to be able to push fast enough in order to justify that strategy.
Yeah. It's going to be interesting, especially, I think, to see the Weaver match up. You know, Weaver running the Deso, matching up against Matumba Man, who's just picked up, almost has the Sanjin Yasha finished. So, and now that Mind Control, he does have the Arcanes up, he has the mech, he can decide whether he wants to go Greaves or Blink next. I think either is really fine. Obviously, they already have the Blink up on Puck, which will help set up the Dark Seer as well.
Yeah, early Greaves, normally not necessarily something that you need to rush, but in a case where your opponent's carry, the only thing he really has going for him is negative armor. Getting that extra armor in an aura is great. It kind of shuts down that Weaver strategy. Gyrocopter's already sitting on top of 20 armor. So that Desolator is going to hurt him, but it's not going to hurt him to the same degree that you would normally expect,
yeah.
Right?
Joys of Agi carries.
Yeah, and not only that, but the just raw armor that goes from the Helm of the Dominator as well. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So
it's going to be rough either way. It will be difficult to take down this Gyrocopter one way or another with Weaver being your primary source of damage.
But I think there's still a lot Stake can do. We haven't seen, I think, Slicks used to his fullest extent yet. I definitely think, oh, we have an engagement up on top. It looks like Era manages to use that time lapse. He's still under the effects of the Dream Coil. He's visible now. He doesn't have... Oh, okay, Kuroki thought he went maybe the other way, but doesn't matter. Era gets picked off by Fada. Jarek's coming in just in case he needs to. And Jarek's actually getting awfully close to a drum. It just feels like all across the map, we can see it in the net worth, but Liquid's just doing better everywhere. Oh, as I say that though, we're gonna see, oh, the nice swap coming out from Jarek's. They're actually gonna glimpse Matoma Man back. There is the Static Storm coming down. Cinderin getting that Shallow Grave, gonna keep him alive. Can he find any more? He's already used that lasso. He can at least Sticky Napalm up. No, Vacuum back before he can do anything. And that'll be
honestly, bad. that's not a terrible trade for State Gaming, considering they had already lost the Weaver and they weren't going to be able to defend a potential push there. Getting Matumba Man, it helps out a lot, and they ended up getting a lot more gold out of that than Liquid did, just because of the way that comeback mechanics work as well.
On the other hand, Kuroki has a Sacred Relic.
Because, you know, why not? Why fix what ain't broke, right? Goes into the Vlads and then into the Radiance. But the interesting thing about the Radiance here is that it really, really will shut down that Weaver, who got a Desolator for his right click. That's all he really provides. And the mischance coming out of that Radiance is going to either make it so that the Weaver has to rush a Monkey King bar, or the Weaver is ineffective throughout these fights. It's not really what you want to be dealing with.
Speaking of ineffective, blown up is Era on the bottom there. We're seeing a Dagon out on the puck. She is being tossed up in the air. We'll see if they can bring down this puck, but a beautiful swap again from Jarek's. The glimpse back, but doesn't seem to matter so much. Fada still doing a lot of damage. Is now stuck in the trees, actually, but they see you, Fada. Can they bring her down on that puck? It's looking like Fada up in the air again. It's living on 4 health. Is Fada really going to get out of this one? Okay.
That's gotta sting a little bit.
Matumba Man just came in and cleaned up the rest of the team that was trying to get Fada, so...
Yeah, and once again, that Weaver going down very early in that fight, because he doesn't have the life or survivability to deal with a single Dream Coil, let alone the Dagon as well. Right, it's just... The Weaver's not designed as a hero to be dealing with that.
Yep, oh, we're gonna be seeing a lasso. There is no Venge right now, so maybe Era can actually get Matumba Man, but they are barely tickling him. You talked about this armor. Era's trying his best, but I don't know if it'll be enough. Throwing out a few more auto attacks, looking like he might need 6 more, and actually gonna be just chased off by that homing missile.
Poor Weaver, he's just completely ineffective here. I mean, he didn't farm tremendously well, but considering his opponents have a massive gold advantage from towers and from kills, just a casual Dagon kill there.
Yeah, Fada really taking advantage of this small health pool on the Weaver, as you said.
Yeah. I mean, Weaver is still sitting on top of, what's his GPM right now, I wonder. It's 376, considering how far behind they are. That's not totally awful.
Well, it was a lot better before these two quick kills in succession. I'm pretty sure he was over 400, as you said. Considering how far behind they are, it's not atrocious. Right now it is. We've now got Kuroki being a real pain to all of them inside of the ancient granite golem. Oh. Radiance middle tower. And also Gyro's going to be picking up an Aegis. It's looking
rough. The problem is, the Weaver doesn't have the flash farm capability to come back from having an ineffective first item choice. He can't go out and get farm here right now. There's just no way he can do it safely. So they basically, State Gaming has to buy the time for the Weaver to get farm as it's brought to them through the lanes to the base. It's going to take a tremendous amount of time, and I just don't think they have that kind of time available to them. How do you think they're going to try to scale this out? Is it just take a team fight based on a tornado and hope for the best, or
I think they have to just
wait it out.
Try to defend high ground. I think that's kind of all they've got going for them. They do have some nice stuff like Static Storm. The Batrider can pull people in. Slick should have some funky stuff coming out of that Invoker. We'll see whether he can do any of it, but instead Fada with the silence opens up, manages to orb away. Slick's blown up by the flat cannon coming out of Matumba Man. He didn't have a second to respond there, and with nothing, I mean, this is the problem with the Disruptor. He has no way of actually stopping this aggression. What's he gonna do? Oh, and speaking of what's he gonna do, he's gonna be vacuumed back. We're gonna see people being blown up. Fog just gonna walk sadly away. Will he fall to their auto attacks? They decide to let him live this time. And while Syndarin is trying to make something happen on the top lane. He's just not in base. I think he has his full stealth up. I'm not sure it does anything at this point in the game.
We're looking at closing in on 1,000 gold.
We have pulled someone into the fountain. We have pulled Puck into the fountain as he was shopping for his dagon, so that's something.
It's a small consolation for their racks. That one kill was worth 1,400 gold, so it's not a good statement toward your chances for success when 1,400 gold swing at 24 minutes is a small consolation.
I definitely think, obviously, we're again in the state where it feels like it's Liquid's game to lose. Oh, we're seeing Slicks go invisible. But it also just feels like, despite having a support in the jungle, I haven't actually been keeping good track of whether Kuro is actually helping out with wards at all, or whether they're really running a solo Jerax support. But despite that, Jerax has been able to get a ridiculous number of wards. There have been sentries all over the map.
I think that this is pretty much, we're in jungle carry territory. This is difficult to classify this lifestealer as a support at this point.
And I think a more, obviously State Gaming's a newer team, and I wonder whether this lineup that Liquid's trying out here, that they've been trying out in a few games, would work against a more disciplined team.
I think if you run it up against more experienced, higher ranked teams, if you run it up against your VG, your EG, your Secret, your OG, somebody like that, I think the early game aggression that those teams tend to bring to the table would make it much more difficult.
Oh, someone's being blown up over here by Fodder. We can hear it, but maybe they'll get the return kill. Fodder using that phase shift. Is he going to be able to blink away? There's a bug on him. He manages to illusory orb and dodge the attacks and another dodge. Let's see if when he comes out of it, he is blown up by the Sunstrike, but now here comes Matumba Man. He is going in on folks. Seal Kid explodes. A gem pops out of him, and that's horrible. That's the transfer over. Oh, the gem that they've needed so much to try to get past some semblance of map control.
If you're going to be this far behind, at least being this far behind with a vision advantage gives you some ability to really do anything. But like you said, there's no semblance of map control without that gem. And the Radiant jungle is so heavily skewed towards the dire Radiant's invasion. There's such a disadvantage there inherently playing from behind. That, once again, I'm just not sure what the play is if you don't have that gem, if you don't have any real control over what's going on.
Yeah, unfortunately, the only buyback is on Slicks, so Slicks needs to make something happen here if he can. But it looks like they're going to be glyphing it up. Let's see. They've got a couple of big potential plays. They've got a lasso. Of course, they have to catch up Jerax, or they're just going to get swapped. And instead, Matumba Man takes their melee racks, looking like he's going to back on out. Oh, there's the blink in two through the vacuum wall. Also, now there's going to be a big cooldown hits on three. Doesn't even matter. Kills them all. Slicks could buy back here, but I'm not sure if they'll buy back or just call it. There's the GG.
Yeah, at this stage, there's not a lot they can do. They fought admirably for a while into a pretty significant deficit. Like I said, they're closing in on 1,000 gold per minute deficit.
Yeah, it was a rough one, but I think State Gaming still, you know, showed us that they had some good coordination areas. I think just a little bit, a little outplayed, to be honest. And the Venge peek into the bat, right, there were also some issues where I think the bat smoked up. Didn't really work out for them, that first smoke blink.
Yeah, I can't disagree with you. That it comes down to, I think, the lack of punishing the jungler and the lack of control on those early gank attempts.
Yeah, so once again, folks, this will be it for the European coverage. There is about, I want to say, an hour or so, an hour and 10 minutes between the Americas and this. I'm probably going to leave the stream up just because we can, but we won't be back for another hour until the next games are here. So, folks, please bear with. I'll just leave some music playing and we'll be back in an hour with the American games. I'm Llama Down Under. I was joined by the Wonder Cow. Any and all feedback? Sorry we had some technical issues at the beginning there. Just having some problems with Twitch. So thank you for bearing with. And we'll be back in an hour. Peace out.